Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, we learned how we can display a text label using the text composable function. And in this video, we will learn about the basics of layout, because most of the time we use multiple components, multiple view components to build our Android UI. And in this video, we will learn how we can do that in Jetpack Compose. So this is my project. This is the same project and I have deleted everything. So in this video, I will create one more composable function that will display multiple things in our UI. And let's define our composable function. The process is same. We will use @ composable annotation and then we will define a function. Let's say for this example, I will define fun user card, or you can name your function whatever you want. Now inside this function, what I want to display is I want to display three things. I want to display an image, a text, and a button. Now I want to align my image to the left, and on the right side I want to display the button and the text. And to do this, we have some basic layout composable functions. The first one is row. So we have row. If you type row, you will get this. And if I control click this row, then you can see this is a composable function and the name of the function is row. So whenever you want to display your components horizontally, you can use this row function. So it is like linear layout, and if you want to create a horizontal linear layout, you have to use row. And one more thing that you have is you have column. Now you can use this composable function to display your components vertically. And you can nest both these functions to display horizontal inside vertical or vertical inside horizontal. So first, I will use a row function and I will create an image to display the image to my UI. So what I will do is inside this trailing lambda, I will create image. And creating an image in Compose is very easy. We just need to use the image function. It is again equivalent to image view that we were using with Android XMLs. So I will use this function that is called image, and it takes two parameters. If you control click this image, then you can see these two parameters are compulsory. So we need to pass a painter that will define what we need to display inside this image, and this is content description. So for the description, we can pass an empty string, or you can also pass null value. And for the painter, we need to define what image or what we want to display inside this image. And most of the time we use a resource image to display inside our image view. And that is why I have a drawable here inside my drawable folder. So I will use that. And to use a resource image, what you need to use is you need to use the function that is called painter resource. And inside this function, you can pass your resource ID. So here I will write r.drawable.icface like this. Now this image will display this image that we are getting from this drawable folder. And content description is just the description of the image, and you can pass empty string for now. So let's build and refresh our preview, but we are not calling this function inside our preview function, and that is why we are not getting any output. So what I will do is I will call my user card here. So you can see we are getting the image here. Now what I will do is I will make the size of the image a little bit small, because I want image to the left of my screen. So to do this change, what we need to do is we need to pass a modifier for our image. First, I will format this code and I will make the arguments on each line. So I can use this option to do it automatically. So we have image, we have content description, we have this drawable resource, and I will pass a modifier. So we need to use this modifier, and I will use modifier.size, and I will pass, let's say, 120 dp. This is the size I want for my image. And then I will use a function that is called clip. And inside this function, we need to pass a shape. And because I want to make my image circular, I will pass circular shape like this. And that's it. Let's build and refresh. But you can see here our image is not fully circular. And to fix this thing, what I will do is I will pass one more parameter or argument, and that is content scale. So I will pass content scale dot crop, and let's build it again. And you can see we are getting a circular image view or image. So we have the image here. Now to the right, I want to display two things in a vertical manner. So what I will do is inside row after this image, I will use column, because this time I want to display the components vertically. So this is column, and inside column, first I will pass text. So we have text, and here I will pass string resource, and I have r.string.dummy text like this. Let's build and refresh. So you can see we are getting our text here. Now after text, I will create a button, and to create a button, we have a composable function that is button. And for button, we have an onClick argument. And to this argument, we pass a lambda, and this is nothing but your callback. And here you can do whatever you want to do when your button is clicked. So perform button click action here. Now inside the trailing lambda of the button, I will pass a text that I want to display for this button. So I will pass a text, and let's say I will write it like view profile, like this. So we have an image, we have a text, and we have a button. Now let's build and refresh. So you can see we have everything in our preview. Now I can add some padding to this row. So what I can do is I can pass a modifier to my row function, and here I will pass modifier fill max width, because I want to fill my row to the maximum width. Then I will pass wrap content height. Then I will put some spacing. So I will write padding, and let's say I will give 12 dp of padding. Then I will pass a border. Let's say I want a border of 1 dp of color. Let's say color dot gray. So this is width and this is color. So we passed fill max width, wrap content height, padding, and the border. And then finally, after border, I can give the padding again. Let's say 12 dp. So in Jetpack Compose, we do not have margin, but we have padding. And padding means giving spaces. So I have given space before giving the border. That means this space that we have outside the border, this is of 12 dp. And after providing border, I have given padding again. And this padding represents the inner spacing between this image and this border. So this is how we can use padding with Jetpack Compose. And we will use padding only for padding and margin. So we have our user card, and we have all the components that we wanted to display in our UI. Now, if I run my application, I will get the same thing in my output. Let's try it. And you can see here we are getting an empty output. It is because I again forget to set the content of my activity. So I will call the function that is setContent, and inside the trailing lambda I will pass userCard, and I will run the application again. And you can see we are getting our userCard. So this is how you can use rows and columns to arrange your composable components. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. In case you have any problem or confusion, you can leave your comments below. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing.